Hey, gang. We're going to be talking about how I made the scratches for my latest character, Leather Scratches. And this is a smart material that was created during the project, and it's going to be available with a bunch of other smart materials and stuff. So it's going to be our base. So let's jump in and get started. First off, I'm going to create a folder. I'm going to name it Scratch Base. We're going to put our base for our scratches here. So I'm going to search for leather. And I want the leather rough. I think it's a base material that comes with Substance, but if not, it's in Substance Source. I'm going to click and drag that up into Scratch Base. Change my scale. Different for different people, but I think 10 worked for what I was wanting. Maybe a little less. Let's try 7. That should do it. Make sure that's in that folder. And then I'm going to create a layer on top of that. And all I want is the height information. We're going to make this a negative height, and then we're going to put a black mask over the whole thing. We're going to go to our brushes and we're going to use Chalk Bolt. It's got a nice hard edge. And then we're just going to block out. Oh, I've got Smudge Brush. Make sure my actual brush is selected. Then we're just going to block out our scratch. Just going to get the shape in there. Nice tapered edges. Let's come in here and maybe add a couple perpendicular notches. Maybe another little scratch over here. And then a third guy, because why not? Alright, cool. So now we got our scratches, the base set in there. Next thing we're going to do is create a second layer. Let's call this rough high. That'll work. Do that. Again, we're going to go in here and grab that leather rough. Drag that to the folder. What do we set that scale up for? Is that 6? 7. Okay, so we're going to put this at 7 as well. Alright, we're going to create a layer in here. Same as we did before, except we're only going to do height, and except we're going to do positive instead of negative. Alright, we're going to put a black mask on this guy. And we're going to use this layer to paint in and give the edges of our leather a little bit of a lip, a little bit of height. And not worried too much about kind of going over here, because it just gives a little bit more depth there, because that layer underneath it is subtracting the layer in the middle. Obviously it's just kind of a middle height, and then this is a positive height, right? So if you paint on top of that, like, it's going to carry through and create another kind of height level, just give a little more depth to our scratch there, which is not bad at all. I'll take it. That works for me. It's kind of like free stuff. Free stuff's never bad. All right, so now we've got that in there, we're going to go over to our smudge tool. And we're going to use smudge tool that I created. I'll share this out. I keep saying it's great. I'm pretty positive I created it at this point. I'm so got so many different brushes and stuff in here. Lose track sometimes. So. We're just going to brush that in until it kind of fades out. We want a little bit of that roughness and that color information, but we're more interested in the height. So we're just going to kind of paint that out as we go. We're gonna do one more pass with a brush. Get a little more depth in there. Just another layer just to kind of increase the complexity. Almost there. Do, do, do. All right, I'm gonna smudge it one more time, but this time I'm going to use the mold. Where did that go? Here we go. Now this should give me a sharper edge. So those the edges of that cut look a little more kind of worn, I guess, or a little less gradual, right? Like it's actually been cut in and, you know, stuff's being ripped apart and torn away from where it naturally would fade. We want something a little more abrupt here. Increase the size on that a little bit. I'm gonna give us a little more edge variety too. Whereas that soft smudge just kinda made everything soft. This gives us a, you know, a little hard edge here and there. Come back in and push back a little bit of that. And then do a little bit of cleanup work with my chalk bold, set the black just in this inside area. Just to clean up just a bit so everything doesn't get too muddy. Alright. I've got that. Alright, next I'm gonna come in here, I'm gonna start adding some wrinkles and stuff and some puckering. So for that, and in this layer we want to set our height, that's it, set to a negative amount, and then we're gonna use brush. There we go. Basic soft, and I've got an alpha that I use that I'll include right here. This guy, it's kind of this kind of a just kind of like random wrinkle brush, the alpha that I generated. And then I'm going to what I want this alpha to be kind of horizontal and perpendicular to the verticality of that line. So I'm gonna adjust my angle. There we go. That's what I want, and I want to increase the spacing. So that is that brush name? Yeah, okay, that's working. I just need to increase my height. Alright. Go. Okay, cool. Just want to make sure that's working right. I'm gonna increase the spacing a little bit and decrease the height a little more. Alright, just gonna run along the sides here. Each of these. And after I have that, I'm gonna use my smudge tool. Get this. And just kind of lightly brush it and start knocking some of that back on the outsides as it's closer to the edge of the tear, scratch. I'm changing my angle too. Also, I want to make sure that I'm kind of looking at this in different kind of light. I mean, not lights, but like angles to get different sheens and stuff like that, just to be able to see the height and what it's doing exactly. Right. Come in here with a soft brush. Without the alpha. Is it alpha? Yeah, okay, it's gone. Good. And then we are going to every now and then just paint, not that small, just a little stroke. We're going to come in after this with our smudge brush and move all the stuff around. Alright, cool. Now I'm going to grab the smudge brush, back to my soft. I'm just going to kind of drag back and forth a little bit. Pull this out. I kind of want, if there are two of these beside each other, I like to do the kind of the Z folds. Go back to my smudge brush down here. knock some of this back. Brush. I'm going to use my super soft. I think this is another custom brush I'll include as well. Same thing, just layering up. Just keep doing process after pass after pass. Just kind of layering up the complexity. It's not like any one of these are that complicated, but when you do them all together and stuff like that, just the sheer amount of things going on starts to add up the complexity of what's going on. And I think you kind of feel that visually, whether you notice it or whether you know it or not, your brain picks up on it. I'm gonna use my soft smooth there. Just knock some of this back. Got my paintbrush, sorry. Soft smooth. There we go. Okay, and the next thing I'm gonna do is create one more layer. I'm gonna set just the height, and this time